Welcome back to another Parse Productions of the UND Open Round 2 Front 9, brought to you by Kestrel Outdoors, OTB Disc, and Throwback Sports. Myself, Ben Kroll.
And Derek Sahr here, and we are going to have an absolute battle. Look at how tight this race is. I cannot wait to see this action happen.
Yeah, Ryan at 13, Aiden at 12, Jamie at 10, and Adam at 9. These guys are going to be battling all around. A lot of birdies to be had out here at this UND course, this Ray Richards disc golf course. Starting off hole one, 396 feet. This is a bomb. But these guys have a little bit of room to work here. It's not the tightest shot off the first round.
Yeah, and again, wind plays a major factor on this course. You know, being North Dakota, not a whole lot of tree coverage in the entire state.
Yeah, but fairly flat as well, too.
But, you know, I believe, you know, Cale helped design this course, and I think he did a wonderful job at working with what he had.
Yeah, Cale and his brother Paul putting in courses all throughout northern Minnesota, starting to venture off into North Dakota, South Dakota as well, too, now. And this is a beautiful property here, overlaying on a golf course. I feel like it mixes really well with that golf course.
Yeah, you're right. They do such a wonderful job. And staying off the golf course itself, but yet making such an amazing course here.
We get to watch Ryan first round. So if you didn't see that, make sure you go back and watch it. He has a big arm.
Yeah, as we can see there, he throws about 440 feet with no effort at all. And if you've watched our coverage before, we all know Aiden. Aiden can throw far. Team MVP. This is always something special to watch Aiden play.
Yeah, and he's really been working on this forehand this whole season and last offseason. And this is not a short hole. That's a big forehand. Great shot.
Wow. Quite impressive as he gets it about 30 feet from the basket, just a little short. And I've actually never seen Jamie play, but I know he is quite the shredder, and he's a southpaw.
Yeah, he's got a big arm, and I remember he toured a couple years ago, but I haven't seen him since then, and he was ripping some shots. I saw him win a couple big tournaments as well, too. I know there's a little bit of coverage out there of him. See him starting off here. A little short, but well within his range.
And Adam Smith, also, I believe, new to the par save coverage. I'm excited to see him play. I've actually seen him at a few tournaments. Haven't gotten to meet him very much, but I know he's got some game. And I think with that shot right there, we're going to be seeing something really cool.
Great shot to start off. Getting a little extra action at the end. We got about 40, 45 feet left. And you can see the tree limbs, the bush just ripping here. Definitely windy today.
Yeah, wow. Even on his putt there, you can really see the wind just take it right out of his hand.
Yeah, I got a little away from him.
And Ryan here, I know he putts with P2, so it is a more of a stable putter. Looks like he's really getting a feel for that wind.
Can't tell if that bush is in the way. Looks like it just barely was.
Yeah, the one obstacle near the basket, and he finds his way behind it.
Jamie's got a really smooth putt.
Wow, yeah, that was sweet. He kind of starts off almost like he's going to do a push, and then he spins it. I like that a lot.
Yeah, really fights through that wind well.
Yeah, you can see how low he gets his arm, and he comes out as like a spin, just dead straight. What a great putt.
Yeah, replay brought to you by Kestrel. They've got some great discs out there. Make sure you check them out. All their coupon codes will be in the descriptions.
Yeah, and you know they have a driver, a mid-range, and a putter. So, Adam gets kind of a nasty spit. But, you know, it's just so nice to be able to purchase all three just in one fell swoop. You know, it's really good to have other companies coming in and supplying discs like that.
Yeah. Aiden, pretty short attempt here at his birdie.
His rocket putt. Aiden also, he putts pretty hard. But dead straight. Great putt, Aiden. Way to start the round off. It's a hole that's tough to get, you know. It feels like a bonus, in my opinion.
Yeah, this is a big hole.
And Adam, kind of with an unfortunate spit, having to tap out for his bogey, but he'll shake it off, and I'm sure we'll see some good action.
Great look of Jamie there on his big lefty shot. Tie at the top there by Ryan and Aiden. I think this will be a common theme, I think, throughout this round, I believe.
Yeah. Jamie's not too far behind. Just kind of hanging there. He's, you know, he's just going to be attacking. As we jump into hole two, 339 feet. Plays for a good backhand hyzer shot into this green. The left side's pretty taken over. These guys were playing it just right of this tree off the tee and having it hyzer in, kind of skipping to the basket more in a sense. The green is quite guarded as well with a lot of pine trees and not a lot of wind up there near the putting green.
Yeah, I think even Jamie will have a line there, being a left-hand backhand player, throwing kind of straight at it.
And Aiden can throw a hyzer, I think. I was talking with Aiden, and the disc that I said that I liked out of MVP, he says he throws it for his roller. And I was like, oh, gee, thanks, Aiden.
Yeah, he's got a lot of power. Yeah, I think Jamie's going to have to keep this low to be able to penetrate through the initial limbs there as you get towards the basket.
Just notices the back of his shirt saying chain wrecked.
Yeah.
that's kind of interesting. I like that.
Great shot there. Puts it within about 20 feet.
Ryan going to probably be throwing that hyzer play that Aiden threw.
A lot of angle there. Gets to the ground pretty quick.
He's got quite a long look to get his two.
Yep.
It looks like Adam's lining up the straight shot, I believe.
Yeah.
Oh, kind of inside straight.
And it's going long there. Showed a lot of power there. Not exactly when he wanted it. And we'll see if he has any lane to the basket, but he's got to be about 45, 50 feet at least.
Just a little short on that putt.
Yeah, if you watch first round, he was close on a lot of those long putts. Can't wait till he starts connecting on those.
Oh, no. Adam hit an early tree for his upshot.
He had a lot to deal with there.
Yeah, he was in the rough. Oh, left side. Unfortunate.
Yeah, very good attempt there. Aiden trying to take solo lead here early in the round. Solid putt.
He does just that. Yeah, let's see that replay here. Just never leaves the height of the basket.
No, he's gotten a lot better at his pace too on the back.
I like his face. I'm so glad that we got to capture that.
Yeah, he knows he got a little lucky there on the left side. But take that all day.
Jamie, I'm kind of a little bit of an obstructed lie here against that tree. But no problem. The walkers. In the background.
Yeah, good start here by Jamie.
Yeah. Can't beat 2 for 2 right there. And he's feeling good about that putt for sure. Especially with that much wind.
Ryan will be tapping in for his par 3 and Adam be following up with his bogey 4, unfortunately.
Yeah, he really didn't have much from that that lie that he had that went a little deep. It looked extremely rough back there.
Yeah, I feel like that's a common theme on this course. A lot of distance control shots.
Aiden's just pure power on the hyzer. And Aiden's got a lead.
Yes, he does.
Nice. Minnesota boy Aiden making the trip to North Dakota to play in this beautiful course. They're jumping into hole number 3, par 4, 645 feet. That does play near that OB bunker and a golf green as well on the left side. These guys are just going to be trying to, well, some of these guys might be trying to take this hole into two parts, but there are some other guys on this card that might be thinking about trying to have a look for the eagle.
Yeah, 645 feet is pretty far, but we saw Ryan get kind of be within 100 feet last time, I feel like.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if the wind was more favorable at this point, but this guy right here.
Yeah, that's another guy that throws really far.
Yeah, I'd love to see Aiden put something really close here. You know, he's really, really trying to stretch something out here.
Yeah, he's looking to put a lot of angle here on the drive. Little low and got a little cut roll there. Should be well, you know, well far enough to get his birdie look at this hole though. And Jamie's another guy that throws over 500 feet on a good day. We'll see what he does with his disc here.
Yeah, I'm really excited to see him play. I have heard a lot about him, being an older school player like myself. Just hearing his name, I'm really excited to see. Wow.
Yeah, you're getting up there in New Year's, right?
Yeah.
You're almost 30? Or?
Well, I'm almost 30, but, man, I mean, I've been playing since I was, you know, 2 years old. And, you know, my dad got me into the sport and everything. And speaking of dad, I always want to give a shout-out to Ryan Muizelaar's dad. He's been at every single tournament that Ryan has played. And Ryan's traveled a decent amount this year. And it's really cool to see his dad out supporting him and everything. So, Big shout out there.
Yep. Yeah, he's a super nice guy.
And I'd like to see Adam put this in a good spot here.
Looks a little low, similar to Aiden.
Just kind of cut out a little bit. Yeah, Adam's still going to have quite a long ways to get to this green.
Yeah, there's a few trees to deal with there, and please turn this over just a little bit.
Yeah, getting caught up. That is a long way, though, to get all the way there. Oh, Aiden's going to go forehand.
Yeah, he's been comfortable with it so far. Looks like he's making a disc change here late.
Now he's going backhand. It sounds like there might be a little bit of dew on the ground. You can hear the squeaking of their shoes a little bit.
Yeah.
That always does play a little bit of a factor. Oh, goodbye. Are you kidding me? He overthrew the basket. Oh my gosh.
I think it was way up there in the air.
He just throws it so hard. Jamie kind of in an uncomfortable lie.
Yeah, and I've seen him do this before. He's got his righty forehand. I always thought this was strange, those players that can throw the same spin but throw forehand backhand in a sense, you know, throw with the other arm.
Yeah.
It seems like there's not much advantage, but we'll see. I mean, it might actually pay off here for him, that righty forehand.
Very interesting. I do like the ambidextrous, Jamie. This is pretty cool to see. Oh, he's got to snake his way in. Yeah, I think the forehand is looking the most comfortable for him. He's got that bush right there.
Yeah, sometimes where I most feel comfortable with the forehand, too, is on a knee. Just feel a little more stable. I feel like when I throw a forehand, it's always because I'm in trouble anyways.
Yeah.
And this has got to get up over that bunker. He has plenty of distance to do that, and that was a great shot.
I think you made the right choice. That was sweet. Yeah, Ryan's a pretty quick player as well. I always forget that. He kind of steps up. He knows what he's going to throw and then goes.
Yeah, we saw him throw this disc a lot first round. Being told that it's his gator, throws it forehand and backhand, it looks like, for a lot of his upshots.
Yeah, I know Ryan's trying to get that manufacturer sponsorship, being unsponsored and everything.
He's got all the game to do it, and he's a young talent.
Yeah, just at 18 years old. Still in high school. You know, I'm sure he's got a bedtime still and everything.
Looks like Adam got stuck up in that tree. That's why we didn't see it finish. And he's still got to be about 100 feet away or so.
The 2-meter rule is not in effect for this tournament, is my understanding.
That's good. That's good.
Well, kind of interesting to see two discs stuck in a tree in two different coverages, because it happened the last round as well.
Yeah, it did. There's not like a ton of trees out here either, and they weren't in pine trees.
No, exactly.
I think Aiden just outside the circle, around circle's edge here, just long. And he has nothing with that pine tree there. That is unfortunate.
Nice, Jamie.
Very smooth there on the putt.
Yeah, his putter is feeling on fire right now. Mm-hmm. And that's the perfect time for it to happen, right there in the second round.
Yeah, replay brought to you by OTB Discs. Be on the lookout for them. And Jamie Peer here, getting a good catch from the strong side.
Yeah, he's got like I said, it looks like he's going to do a push putt almost the entire time until the very last one when he comes up, he does a spin putt, which, you know, I prefer the spin putt myself, and I really like to see that. It's really cool. Interesting form. Good form. It's Adam as well. No slouch on the putting green.
Yep, saving his par. Ryan making this hole look pretty easy, but can't tell if there's something in the background or that limb got in his face.
A blind putt by Ryan. Couldn't even see the basket. And Aiden, pretty frustrated he wasn't able to at least give it a run and having to lay up there.
Yeah, Ryan, good look there on his drive, getting that stroke back quick on Aiden. And Jamie with the birdie as well, too. It's getting tight here at the top, and these guys all throw bombs.
Jeez, two tied, one stroke off. Oh, man, this is going to be a battle.
Yeah, here we're hole four, 270 feet, par three. Looks like there's a big righty backhand hyzer or a nice straight gap. I think some of those guys were taking a low hyzer as well, too. A few branches to deal with.
Yeah, a lot of these shots are very low ceiling and having the disc, you know, I see a lot of them playing the skip shot. You know, it kind of reminds me of Arizona golf, you know, playing that skip shot and dry grass and everything.
Yeah, a little bit shorter grass, nice, well-maintained grass on a golf course. Jamie looking to keep his hot streak going. I think he's 3 for 3 so far.
Yeah, it'd be really awesome to collect some more birdies out of him. Oh, no.
And it looks like he yanked that one pretty good. It definitely seems a more favorable hole for a righty backhand, though.
Ryan telling the disc to get left, get left. As he's lining up his shot.
This looks like a little high. But he misses all the branches, and he's got about 25, 30 feet left.
Yeah. Wonderful shot. And Aiden just going to be trying to follow suit. Oh, he's going with the forehand. I did expect Aiden to go with the backhand on this hole, but you know, I'm sure there's a reasoning for him throwing the forehand.
Yeah, he's really been looking comfortable so far with that forehand.
Yeah.
He's been choosing it a lot when he's at open shots. And I really thought this was more favorable for a backhand. And now he...
Yeah.
You're making this tough, Aiden.
Yeah, see, I know Aiden's game. I know he's going backhand. Come on. Oh, geez.
Oh, and he's going big backhand. We didn't see that first round. Going long.
Yeah. It looks like he was hoping for a crash, but it didn't hit a thing and just kept going.
Mm-hmm. Looks like Adam's lining up the Ryan line, going a little lower. This looks pretty good here.
Yeah. Great shot.
Yep. Inside the circle for his look for a birdie. Jamie just trying to get up and down. He's got a little bit of work to do.
Yeah. Looks like he's going to have to play something pretty low here. It's skipping. And he does just that.
Yeah, great shot to give him a look, but he's still got 35, 40 feet left for his par.
And as the day progresses on, the wind is only going to become more and more of a factor as well. And Aiden, this would be a really big putt for him.
Yeah, and see the branches just moving everywhere, a lot of wind. See if Adam can't capitalize. And he was just outside the circle.
And this would be a really good putt out of Jamie here if he can capture this.
Yeah, being a stroke off the leaders, he really doesn't want to lose one to him.
Jeez. He's so automatic. What a great putter. Nice putt.
Yeah, it's good to see him back. He's got such a solid game.
Yeah, he gets so low.
And just no wobble either.
Kind of reminds me of Louis' putt a little bit, Louis Laporta, with yeah. That kind of laser beam spin putt. And Ryan, all day.
Yep, solid putt for the solo birdie. Oh, good catch there by the basket.
Yeah.
Just a little right side.
I also noticed one thing about Ryan is after he throws his shot, he keeps his bag on his shoulder. So, like, if he's first on the tee box and he throws a drive, he'll keep his bag on his shoulder until everybody else is done. He likes to be up and ready.
Ready to go.
Yeah. And not too happy. He was really hoping to hit something on that big hyzer play.
Yeah, good look at Adam's drive here, keeping it nice and low. Ryan taking that solo lead back.
Yeah, there's going to be so many lead changes What a fun battle to watch.
Yeah, and this is a great course. My name's Scott
Madison, and I'm a calisthenics athlete. I chance rubber bands because they improve my strength, my stability, my flexibility, and I can take them anywhere. It's all about training smarter with natural movement. What I love best about rubber bandits is seeing noticeable gains in my physique and my athletic performance. It helped me progress from assisted movements to freestyle flow. Exercise your freedom and join me in the Rubberlution.
Join the Rubberlution and get yourself trained in this offseason, guys. Rubber bandits. Brings us to hole 5, par 5, 843 feet. This is a tight one here off the tee. Can't really air it out a ton as you have all these branches to deal with.
Yeah, and the first few hundred feet, or the first about 100 feet are so treacherous. You hit one of those and you're probably going to have to just go out for getting a par on the hole. Yeah. But as long as you can just get off the tee, past that 100 feet mark, then 100 foot mark, I'm sorry, then you're sitting great. You know, you have a great shot at an eagle opportunity even.
Yeah, you really saw the hole open up there a little bit in the middle of the hole and then got tight again there towards the green. Ryan throwing a great forehand. Let's see that thing fly. And I think he's out there. You might have a good look at this and have a chance to get up and down from there. The extra 50 feet would have been nice, though, if that thing wanted to hit the branches, maybe even been a little further than that. And I think that's the play. I think you want to finish a little off to the right. You have a little bit more opening into the green from there.
And not too sure what Jamie likes to throw here, but I imagine it being something somewhat stable, having it finish right, like you said.
Yeah, I know he used to be on Team Pro Discus a couple years ago when he was touring. Looks like it got a little high on him, but still got out there. Right around where Ryan is, maybe a little bit further down the fairway. Aiden need a little room here.
Yep, yeah. You know when Aiden needs room, you're going to see something cool.
And we didn't see anybody go big last round, so this will be interesting. It's going up and over the trees.
Gone.
Insane.
Yeah, that may need to... I think that touched the stratosphere. Not too sure. We may have to get our experts on that one.
Yeah, hard to tell how much distance he got compared to Ryan and Jamie as they were on the other side of the fairway.
Oh,
interesting forehand roller here by Adam. But I think a roller is not a bad play with the low ceiling that they do have.
Yeah, and you know, just getting out to the opening, and if that's what he's most confident with, that is, you know, I believe is a good shot on this hole. But it's just so technical right off the tee.
And you a card or a bag guy?
Oh, man, I'm a bad guy all day. My buddy, shout out to Taylor Lupton, he is always telling me to get a cart because he's in the cart life now, and he says his back feels so much better. Yeah. So I'm just a bad guy, though. I don't know. I'll take the back pain. You know, I'll deal with it when I'm 50.
Carts are nice to use once in a while.
Yeah.
But on a good golf course like this, they work out really nice.
Yeah, mostly flat. Easy to roll on. Sit down on them.
Having a seat helps sometimes on a big course.
Yeah. Yeah, I just sit on the grass. Is Aiden putting some powder on his hands.
A little baby powder there.
Yep, I know he sometimes thinks he's LeBron James doing that, so glad he didn't throw it into the air.
Let's see if you can throw this one in the basket here. Give yourself an eagle look at this hole. Like he might have caught a tree here.
Yeah, a little short, not exactly where he wants to be. I think Ryan and Jamie are in prime time spots to attack this green.
Ryan needs that to flip up a little bit more. And he should be just fine to get up and down from there. Bush line, he might have to deal with those bushes. A couple trees there on his upshot.
And I wonder if Jamie's looking to get an eagle out of this. His drive was so far up the fairway.
And he's got all the distance if he hits the line. Good looking drive there. Didn't quite get it to flat. But he does not have much left there.
Yeah, holy cow. That's you couldn't put the disc in a better spot. Aiden really needing to put this close to keep the pressure onto Ryan.
And he got a little lucky there. Could hear him. Didn't quite finish left like he wanted to. It was really riding straight on him.
Adam with a little bit of work left for to try to get up and down for his par here.
Should be looking up that lane pretty nice, though.
Yeah. You mentioned earlier that side with the forehand approach is a little easier to access. Oh, thought he forgot a disc. Oh, he did. Yeah, he shook his head. He knew it. He forgot his disc. That happens to the best of us, Ryan. Don't worry. You're young.
Yeah, that's pretty routine from where he is.
Yeah. One of the easiest birdies ever for him, I guess. Jeez.
Let's see what Jamie has here, but he's got to be within 100 feet, I think, even.
Like a driver to play maybe a low shot skipping. Like we said before, the grass is susceptible to a lot of action with a driver.
Yeah, looks like they had a nice day. Sun shining. Always energizes me on the course.
Oh my
he
gosh.
Was running that. He's probably got a good 30 feet left back now.
Did he have a driver in his hand?
I couldn't tell. It definitely looks a little wider rim than a putter, that's for sure.
Yeah, and the way it flew at the end, it did look like one. It's a nice putt for the birdie. Knowing it's close, that's a pressure putt if I've ever seen one. Adam.
Just not having a good day yet. Hopefully he can turn things around.
Yeah. Some unfortunate kicks and spits. But
he's been close to a few putts here.
Yeah, just inches away.
Yeah, that guy, I don't know if he's missed one yet.
Yeah, if he's in the circle, you can just count it already.
And these guys all continue to battle here. Ryan will maintain the lead going into the next hole. Aiden going big off the tee up and over all those trees.
Yeah, I don't think it was quite his stratosphere shot, actually. I think it was just a little short of it. Yeah, we have such a great battle between these guys as we jump into hole 6, 308 feet. Most players will be throwing the backhand hyzer to the basket. You do have that green right behind it to the right, but they want something fading left, so hopefully it shouldn't be too much of an issue for these players.
Yeah, 308 feet, this one is definitely a very gettable hole for these guys. I feel like Cale uses the land very well out here at this Ray Richards golf course. And we saw that green kind of push these guys to the left a little bit. They didn't want to get on that, but to get around all these trees, you definitely got to hang it out to the right a little more than you may feel comfortable sometimes.
Yeah, and landing short of the basket really causes some big skips on that dry ground, but
wow,
landed right on the pin, you know, and do that.
That almost went in. That was right on the basket and landed in the soft grass, kept it right by it. See what kind of line Jamie has as a lefty player here.
looks a little more tunneled up for him than for the righties.
Yeah, he's going to power something straight at the basket. Doesn't want too much fade as it brings him towards that golf green. Another 5-10 feet, and I think probably would have skipped more towards the basket as it was getting close to that dirt.
Yeah, he's right in the heart of that that dirt there for his putt. As Aiden steps up and throwing a hyzer. A little more of a spiked angle.
Yeah, he got the thing way in the air. It looked like he was well short. Not exactly sure what happened there. If just put a little too much height on it.
Adam's just not sure what to do. It looked like he walked up like with his hands up. Like I don't know.
That was just how he checks the wind or something.
Yeah.
And maybe he doesn't have quite the arm to get all the way around the trees trying to go straight at the basket with this forehand. Yeah. Long outside look.
Aiden, the long look, but a look nonetheless. Oh my gosh.
That was a good 70-foot putt, and he made it look like it was 40.
Yeah. He's probably like, oh, I shouldn't step this. I'll go to the next tee pad, you know, or something, because of how hard he putts. Adam, that tough downhill putt with that fast green. Not a bad play to keep it low like he did, though.
Jamie, knowing how close Ryan is, doesn't want to give another one up to the leader. And that putt is just looking so clean right now.
Yeah, I wonder what music he's listening to. Or maybe he's listening to a talk show.
I don't know. Yes, comment below what you guys listen to on the course.
Yeah, I'm going to go with he's listening to Parsave production. I'm going to go with Earth Day. He's just listening to the commentary.
Ryan making easy work, and Adam and Aiden should be cleaning up for their pars. Look, Adam making that a little interesting. Can see he's repping his hometown Bemidji Disc Golf Club shirt.
Yeah, I ain't not too happy about that par, knowing how close it is up there. Jeez. Such commitment to those shots as well that Jamie puts on that.
Yeah, I mean, it's, like you said, it's tight here. These guys are going to be battling all day. Hope to see some lead changes. Throwback Sports, get you one. Has some pretty sweet backpacks with coolers in them. Good for the whole family, good for those casual rounds. Again, go support those companies that support our disc golf coverage as we lead into hole 7 here, par 4, 595 feet. We saw last time, if you land over to the left a little bit, it's a little cleaner look into the green. Either way, it's a pretty much a two-shot hole. I think it's going to be tough for these guys to get all the way there on the line that they have.
Yeah, I think the only possible way would be some monstrous roller, because this hole does play a little bit uphill. Kind of hard to tell on the camera a little bit. He didn't even watch it. He just threw it and walked away. He was like, I know where it's at. I played here before. I know where that disc is going.
Yeah, a lot of these par fours, that kind of 6 to 650 range, they don't need a ton of distance off the tee. You just got to put it in the right spot. Big lefty shot here by Jamie. This thing is cruising.
Yeah. Wow. What a drive. You couldn't even place it in a better spot.
Aiden going to try to match that. He's got a big James Conrad type run up.
Oh, geez.
And he throws really overstable discs.
Yeah, there was a bit of a sonic boom. But still, look at where Jamie is, you know? Like,
yeah.
Jamie is right there with Aiden. And I haven't seen Jamie play until now, but I know Aiden can crush a disc. Oh, it's right in Adam's backswing. The church bell goes. Ringing. I mean, so be it.
Must be Sunday.
Yeah.
Good rip there by Adam. He might have a little tougher look into the green. Few trees in his way on that right side.
Yeah, I always say nothing really, like, distracts me. People talking, you know, some rustling of the leaves. That stuff doesn't bother me, but it's if something is just, all of a sudden, like a bang.
It's a sudden movement, a sudden sound.
That's what screws me up. So if you guys ever want to razz me, that's the way to do it.
Leaked a little left for him there, but he might still have an outside look at this basket for his... That looks like he's right on the circle's edge, maybe.
Yeah, from where he was, that's such a tough angle to keep it so low and not have it, like you said, leak left too much. You know, he gave himself an opportunity for his birdie.
Ryan, again, really liking this American flag-stamped gator for his upshots. Need some action here right to left. Does get some, but still ends up a little short.
Ben, you're calling the shots. That was, he needs some action. He got it.
Yeah. Jamie probably less than 200 feet, maybe in close to 150 feet to this hole.
Yeah, it'd be nice to put this one really close. Well, Jamie can just put it anywhere in the circle, and the putt's probably going to go in.
Yeah, and this is a newer course to the area. Cale just put this course in this summer. Great shot by Jamie, keeping it close to the basket.
Yeah, and should be routine birdie.
Yep, and Aiden even closer than Jamie. It's absolute bombs here by these guys.
I think he's debating whether or not to jump putt it, but I think he's going to throw it. Aiden has quite a long jump putt as well.
Yeah, it doesn't take much effort for him. And that was a pure up shot right underneath the basket.
It doesn't get much more perfect than that. All right, we've seen some unfortunate stuff happen. And I'd like to see this putt go in. Oh, no. Just left it a little high. And when the pressure's on, Ryan will shine. Great putt. Downhill. Looking right at those reeds.
Yeah, he doesn't want to give any strokes to these guys. He knows how close of a ballast is going to be all around.
Jamie left with just a little bit, 20 feet here. Never a doubt.
Yeah, not much is going to change at the top there with those three. They just keep getting birdies.
Yeah. It's just who's ever going to have the most birdies is going to win this one. And, you know, not a lot of mistakes going on at the top, honestly. Nice putt from Aiden.
Good huck face there.
Yeah. You can see, too, his arm just kind of twitching and exploding right at the explosion zone, as I like to call it, when you're pulling from your chest and put so much power behind it.
And Jamie's only missed one hole so far.
Yeah.
He's trying to keep it close at the top. So we enter into hole 8, par 3, 315 feet. Again, we got that tall grass on the right side. The hole's going to be mostly blind for these guys. We'll have to see if Jamie pulls out a forehand or something here as a lefty.
Yeah, it is a difficult green as well with those pine trees right near the basket on the left. And a blind shot, but there is a flag on top of the basket that I believe you can see the very tip top of it.
Ryan trying to get a good view at that flag we were talking about.
Yeah, I'm sure Aiden doesn't have to look twice. That guy's, what, 6'3"?
Yeah, at least.
Yeah. Man, I always wonder, how many discs do you think are in those reeds? I mean, I know it's a newer course, but...
Ryan just getting over them.
Yeah. That just looks like if you threw one in there, I wouldn't even... Ugh, that would be a very tough get back.
Yeah, and we saw some people playing from the tall grass in the last coverage, so I don't know if it is OB like we may have mistakenly said before. But you don't want to be in it, that's for sure.
Yeah.
It looks like it's over your head.
Yeah, when the reeds are taller than you, you do not want to be in the middle of that.
Saw a tough lefty shot there by Jamie as he's got those pine trees coming into the green. See what kind of putt he has. This looks pretty wide by Aiden, but he throws very overstable discs.
Yeah, found its way back.
Going a little long.
Mm-hmm.
It's usually the miss for him.
Yeah, no kidding. Aiden's miss is, you're right, is usually long. See, I'm more about Adam's height, and that's probably what I would be doing, too, to be able to see the top of that flag.
Doing some bunny hops.
Ooh, and that looks a little leaked left.
Yeah, I didn't quite give it a chance. He's got a lot between him and the basket still.
I think it's on the edge.
Having to do that forehand approach. Hopefully that pine tree's not too much of a factor for him. Oh, no, it is.
And he's got a good 35, 40 feet left from inside that pine tree. Jamie, maybe a little something here.
He hit the basket on that. Holy cow.
That was that same orange disc, I think. I don't know if it's a mid or...
Yeah, I'm not sure. I know, yeah, some people do like to putt with their mid-ranges. Oh, as Aiden leaves it just a little short.
Yeah, Ryan looking to collect the only birdie on the card.
This would be a great pickup.
Does not take his time at all. Felt very confident with that putt and hit a dead center. Circle's edge here from Adam. He's been in some tough spots today.
Yeah, he's kind of just been unlucky on the green.
Aiden and Jamie should be tapping in their pars here.
When it's windy, do you ever rush your putt? And you're like, if there's a lull in the wind, do you ever like get your putt out there, or do you go through your routine most of the time?
I try to go through a routine as much as I can at the same time. I don't want to say I need to pump it three times and then putt.
Yeah.
No, it's still a feel for me. I want it to be a feel.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, I know some people like different feelings on that, so.
Yeah, Brian extending his lead there. He's got three strokes on the card.
As we go into our final hole of this front nine battle. Hole nine, 305 feet. You have to throw over some more of those tall reeds that are taller than most humans. And the green is well protected, as like we always say most of these greens are. And the grass is really thin, so it does play a lot of skip. And the wind, as always, playing a major factor at these North Dakota courses. I almost think the forehand is the play to access this green a little bit easier than the backhand.
Yeah, there's more trees on that right-hand side of the green. And then there's one pine tree just long of the hole, too. You don't want to go too far past. And Ryan throwing a perfect shot. That was an absolute gem.
Yeah, wow. Just rolled it around the pin.
This should shape really well for Jamie here to keep his hot streak going.
Yeah, after... missing that last hole, I'm sure he'd like to get right back on to where he was. Oh my gosh. It's still a great shot, but that is so unfortunate. I was going to do the exact same thing Ryan's did.
Yeah, I was going to coast you up right to the basket.
But it hit that freshly born tree right by the basket.
Aiden going with that forehand as well, trying to bring the basket in left to right, trying to bring the disc in left to right. And that is just great. Following Ryan's line really well.
And this is that backhand line that's going to be very difficult to access the screen.
Yeah, it looked like he pulled it a little wide and also going a little long, and he's going to have a lot of trouble getting to this hole.
Yeah, those pine trees really punish you if you do go long.
And he's probably just trying to lay something up, try to get within 15 feet of this basket so he can get an easy three. Wow, he was running that.
Wow, very impressive to be able to give that a run. So much Anheuser and speed control.
Yeah, I kept it close still as well.
Yeah, I highly doubt Jamie saw how unlucky he got, so I'd really be cool to see him capitalize on this birdie.
Yeah, knowing Ryan and Aiden are underneath the basket as well, too.
Just a little high.
Yeah, and he went to a straddle, so something must have been in his way.
Adam. Another chain out.
It's been all over those chains.
Yeah. Man. Oh, I feel so bad for Adam. He's had unlucky lies and some tough chain outs. That's the worst. When you know you're hitting the basket, you're hitting the chains, and just not quite sticking. There's just that one inch that you need to change.
Yeah, you're trying to make all those little adjustments, and they just don't seem to be putting it in the basket. You saw Aiden and Ryan tapping in there. Ryan going to keep his three-stroke lead as we finish up the first half of the second round. Again, thanks for coming in, watching us at the UND Open, brought to you by Kestrel Outdoors, OTB Disc, Throwback Sports. It's been Ben Kroll on the mic.
With Derek Sahr, and don't forget to tune in for the next half because I am very excited to see these guys shred this course.
Yeah, you're going to want to watch the finish on this, guys.
Take care.